I've been working for Two Men in a Truck for the last 5 years on and off. I've completed over 1,000 moves now, all around Wisconsin and Wisconsin to South Carolina, Massachusetts to Arizona, doing interstates. This was the highest paid opportunity available to me until 2020. The US Census, federal government job came along and gave me an opportunity there. Starting pay at Two Men was 14 an hour, which was already the highest I was going to be paid, and then with the tips on top of that, I thought I could really stack some chips, sign-on bonus and all. I realized the camaraderie right away on training day one. I didn't know what to expect from the other guys, but it was a nice surprise. My trainer was also a boxing trainer and studying law, so he was a passionate fellow. He was tough, and I only had two others with me in this training group. It was August in Wisconsin, so it was really hot, sunny, and humid. We were soaked through our clothes, and we had to encourage each other. Our job was to carry off half the truck and then bring it across the parking lot, beat up furniture and appliances, bring it across the parking lot into the building, up the stairs, into the shop, and then once we had it all in there, take it in there downstairs, back over to the truck, and load it up. I mean, I could barely move after the first day. One of the other guys quit. I was coming back either way, but I was, then excited to see these other guys again. Communication. We developed this certain level of respect for each other doing this work, knowing that we're all sacrificing our bodies to get the job done. At this job, hard work will make you friends on the trucks, work friends at least. The office doesn't see much of what happens in the field, but they might catch wind of it too and give you driver mover of the month, get $100 and a certificate. I got the dub a few times myself. Actually, I was competing against the other surviving person in my training class for a while. You can also win gas cards and other little rewards. The owners of the Madison franchise own all of the Wisconsin franchises now for Two Men in a Truck. But even when it was just the Madison one and Racine, they were paying for breakfast. Not every day, but during the monthly meeting and every once in a while. Sometimes we have fruit to grab on the way out, coffee, hot chocolate, water. And there's an occasional cookout or pizza party. We have to pay for our uniforms, but they'll provide the hand warmers and face mask, first aid supplies, things like that. So it's safety first. We have a lot of freedom from management on this job, working on the trucks. We see them in the morning at the shop, and then after we're done, sometimes they'll spot check us. But for the most part, we're out by ourselves. Two men in a truck, two of us in a 26 foot long, 13 foot high truck, box truck. And we coordinate with the customer, manage our time to fit the different jobs, do all the paperwork and the job itself. They don't even cold call for business at the Madison office. We are kings and queens, if you believe it. The office is almost entirely female, but I've worked with two different ladies on the trucks that did a great job. I love the diversity on the trucks too. It's like a third German, a third black, and a third Mexican. It fluctuates. I used to speak more Spanish there, which was dope. I was speaking daily when I was out west with my Spanish friend, and it was cool to find a place coming back where I could use it on the job. Even if I'm still not where I want to be professionally, it was something. And a lot of interesting people do this work. Many vets, students, fathers, multi-talented guys with several side hustles, rappers, musicians, drawers. Many are trying to escape a life hindered by discrimination, poverty, crime, and disability. It's taken some getting used to going from this to UW. But I'm just keeping myself boring and work-oriented there right now, networking and offering up some PG-rated, fluffier things from my life that they can listen to without wincing or throwing a tantrum. You know how those office people are. I went to our first ever yearly party at the Harley-Davidson Museum in Milwaukee last year, and that was lit. We did two softball teams. Two Men offers paid and unpaid philanthropy opportunities too. I've done work with Toys for Tots and Second Harvest several years, and also with CARE Wisconsin and DAZE. Two Men in a Truck was started in Michigan, is nationwide, but Madison is one of the top locations. With UW, the capital, and rapidly expanding science and technology markets taking off in Madison, thousands of people are moving in and out of this small city every year. So Two Men and a Truck is the biggest moving company in town. There you go. I didn't have the chance to go too far from the get-go, but I showed up, kept my head down, kept grinding, and eventually landed the big jobs with key clients in more complex moves and unique environments. And that really adds a lot of color to the job. I greatly appreciate all the opportunities that I was permitted to have in this company. And I made the best of it. I'm very good at this. Made sure to show up on time and get as many jobs as I could right out the gate and climb the ranks. I think I hit overtime my second week on the job. I met Splitty and we teamed up in my first month. We became a crew. And when you find your everyday partner on this job, it gets a lot better. Brett, aka B-Rhett, aka Putting M in Madison, in Madison. He keeps a positive attitude. Every morning we work together. It's, "Hey, how you doing, bro? You ready to get this work?" He has jokes, but he's also willing to listen to difficult topics, and offer his thoughts. This was a tumultuous time for me mentally, and he was a phenomenal friend. Brett, you're a phenomenal friend. And coupled as a counselor and also a driver, when I was getting off the street and then my car was having issues, he was giving me a ride every day for a while, and then whenever I was, having these car problems, just a good guy. And he's a creative, a rapper, and a producer, and got back into it over the past few years. Countless truck cab freestyles on the road, bouncing our music off of each other, going through beats. We've taken albums of photos and videos, and I still have to go through hundreds of those. I still work a job every month or so, but I've been sticking around mostly to see my boy. We met at this place and we've traveled the country due to this job, so it's been hard to step away for good. The new gig has been going well. It's in IT and through Wisconsin Foundation and Alumni Association. I've been applying for UW and UW affiliated jobs since 2012. So I've been holding on to this moving position to see the homie, but it's also hard to believe that, I finally made it out of this insane stretch of discrimination and torture and got into an office position. I know when I first started this new job, I was concentrating on doing a great job, all the same as when I started at Two Men, ironing my clothes and taking notes, learning and staying busy. But I thought every little mistake was going to get me fired. I'm not the kind of person to lie about my mistakes, so I wasn't doing that. But I had a strong feeling I was going to get, brought aside for any little reason and terminated for whatever. At the same time, I was heavily harassed daily by several people in my department in IT at WFAA for my first 8 to 9 months. I've already talked about that. Even so, it was still and is still worlds better than the other job, the brutally difficult and egregiously stressful occupation of the lowest American class. I held on to the moving job because I thought they would come for me again. And they did, as expected. Most recently, the operations team at Two Men in a Truck has been going around the office claiming that I'm not showing up for shifts since I lowered my hours there. Didn't expect that, but it's not surprising either. I mean, but this is after years of work for this place, this continued anti-diverse, fake woke office culture of America. It seems to be fueled by this endless vein of insecurity and laziness, not serious work. It's not just corporate white collar America, it's an office worker thing. Even transitioning from the field to the office, I've seen it plenty of times at Two Men in a Truck. It's not something I see at UW, but people flip like a coin, easy. It's like nothing. In Wisconsin, the winter is the worst time in the moving industry. The work drops to a point where you have to get another job or start filing for unemployment to make up the hours. The ice makes every step a risk. People are trash at salt in their driveway and their sidewalk before we come to do the move. Frostbite's a real threat. You're also going from below zero outside to 70 plus inside. So it's smart to dress in layers, but Then you're adjusting throughout the day to maintain any kind of comfort. Bringing extra clothes if yours gets sweaty so you can swap them out. We joke that the only other people we see working outside in the winter are charter techs and garbage men when they actually have to step out of their truck. After I made it through the first one, it was my goal to take as much of the winter off as I could for years to come doing this job. I was diagnosed with arthritis a few years ago in my legs, knees, and that on top of the scoliosis that I've had for a while now. It's just really difficult doing this kind of work, man. It's like my alarm went off and I felt like I had to, actually pry my 80-pound eyelids open, grip my bed and, pull myself up with both hands like an assisted sit-up and wait in this slouched, semi-conscious state, for a few minutes until the head stops pounding and the voices stop screaming, or a few of them, then grab my legs one by one and swing them over the side of the bed and fall into my morning stretch routine. I got a lot stronger, of course. Some of the heaviest items I've lifted with others. The heaviest stuff you're gonna have to do, man, it's just how it is. Grand piano, player piano, gun safes, treadmills, commercial printers, exercise bikes, marble and granite slabs, commercial meat slicer, and electric sofas are horrible. Stop buying those. A lot of these lifts, I was lifting 300 plus pounds in strange, awkward positions, going through the conditions and the different environments that we're in, stairs or hill or whatever. Rain, sleet, snow, blizzard, windstorm, freezing temperatures, high humidity, piss, shit, dust clouds, maggots, mice, and too many bitch ass customers. Stories for lifetimes, though. Food, too. The KT is pretty much an everyday thing, or twice a day, and some folks bring their meals, but your boy gets hungry. And we get per diem on interstates and overnights too, so I've been maxed out in restaurants all throughout the Midwest, especially all around Wisconsin, of course, more than anything. But a few of the memorable meals, I had a phenomenal burger and what do they call it? Potato string fries in Tulsa, delectable bluefin and oysters in Cambridge, Massachusetts. Some A1 tongue tacos in northeastern Texas, and much more. It can be satisfying clearing out a house and getting all the stuff onto the truck, and then vice versa on the other end. Gives you easily understandable order and feel of completion. You need to keep calm under pressure and fight through many problems that arise on these jobs to get people into their new living space. Working as a full-time mover will make you a stronger person overall, and I embrace that growth that came with the job. But the white-collar, privileged, ignorant, uneducated, soft, whiny gossip culture works hard to enslave this working class however possible. Many times this tradition is passed down generation to generation. Other people self-retard themselves into this state by their own adult-age choices. One of their central tenets is this belief that I've always had this privilege that they have to choose the jobs that I do from a list that includes the easy, simple, safe, white-collar office jobs that pay livable wages, offer benefits and advancement potential, and huge societal advantages. And then the other choices that I have on this same list. The back-breaking, dangerous, slow-paying jobs that don't offer benefits or room for professional growth, security, rights, or widespread praise and opportunity from society. So their mindset is that I choose to work all these terrible jobs to pay my bills for the last 15 years plus, including two men for the last five stretch. These fantasies are often intertwined heavily with centuries of cultural advantages for their people to the point they believe lies over facts delivered straight to them in person. I could tell them my life story line for line, and it's not believable to them. And that's their choice to believe that. They say that I like being outside, a favorite phrase nuanced by proponents of slavery culture. They say that I need to do something physical and active. It's good for me. Slavery, again. I wouldn't fit into the office culture. Or, it's competitive. Listen, it's not competitive. There are a lot of people in adult age America in this group, American adults, but it is not a tough job market, especially now. They love to say that I would be bored working in an office too. They hit me with the classic, that's what you get. That's what you deserve for fill in the blank with anything related to my life, loser. Or, life ain't fair. You chose to fill in the blank, scumbag. Or they say that you create your own problems. It's all in your head, or something. Oblivious and proud of it. Gaslighting culture to the core. How about I get paid to work out? It's another common phrase used by customers and those in the industry not with my name. Other people like the job. Good for them. Also, I'm getting paid to do the work that others are incapable of doing, the work that they refuse to do and have the option in life to not do. Obviously, you don't get bitches doing this job. Stop asking. You are literally referred to as the help. Or, I bet you sleep well at night. Another one of those. Yes, I sleep well at night when I've done a good day of slave labor. Hardy har har. Listen, I've worked these shit jobs while going to school, while working internships and other part-time jobs related to my career path, while freelancing, so that one day I don't have to work the shit jobs anymore. Not if you understand. Thank you, Lisa Paley, Brett Split Gerber, and all the homies that made this transitional experience one that I'll cherish for the rest of my life. Here goes the video.
Guys, Cliff, we're out here doing a two trucker today. So we're gonna be on the trucks, showing you how to get big and get her done.
What's up, everybody? It's Brett, aka Splitty, aka the Vanilla Gorilla, because I put the in Madison. We're about to do this move from Prairie du Chien up down to Stoughton, which is just a loading hole. We're gonna show you how we get it done with efficiency. Get those tips.
Let's go, let's get it. Let's stop wasting time, guys. Money to be made. Oh, wait. Oh, hold on. I gotta go get something real quick.
All right, just a second, bro. I gotta grab something. Hold on.
Oh, shit. Hey, man, I gotta go get something.
Hey there, Bob. It's Brett with the Moving Service. I just want to let you know we're all ready to go and we're heading out. We'll be there in a couple of hours. If there's anything you need, this is my cell. I'm ready to get her done. Are you ready to get her done, Bob? We're about to move you and get you to brand new places. All right, we'll see you soon, bud.
All right, bro, we gotta stop.
Yeah, we'll just go to the Quick Trip up there.
You gotta pick up your morning essentials: an orange, cigarettes, gallon of water, Bang energy drink, and you should know the Blue Raz is the best one. What'd you get, bro?
I got very nutritious breakfast, two slices of pepperoni pizza, good way to start the day. I got a Red Bull ready to rock, so I'm gonna devour this and then that'll give me the energy and strength I need to move them pianos and couches and all that fun stuff.
Thank you.
to bring tools, so you never know what that could be. Travel time, 4 hours, 58 minutes, day 1 load, hold overnight, day 2 unload. Let's take a look at the items. Boxes, 151 total items. What is it? 85 boxes.
Just boxes.
Bedroom, we got a bed, a couple dressers, another bedroom.
Got it.
Kitchen stuff, office, a couple bookcases, patio furniture, and then the basement, which can be scary.
Got anything heavy?
Buffet, exercise bike.
Not a problem.
Yeah, we'll see. So it's a full move.
Either way, it doesn't matter how many items. I've seen it on Google Maps. It looks like a ranch house. Should be pretty easy. The only thing we gotta do is bring stuff up from a basement. But if you see my calves, I could probably do a piano by myself. This is nothing. Easiest two trucker we'll probably ever see. Yo, I'm gonna just clean this up right here. See them pads hanging? We work in the snow, they get wet, they gotta hang dry. Let me handle those and then I'll be in to get this move rolling.
Okay, be ready. I'll pad and wrap. I gotta put it on the garage, so. Take my time. Taking potted plants though. I'm not supposed to. But here's a grill. Just got some weight. So we can go by the bottom.
Well, hold on. Yeah, that seems dirty.
All right, you ready?
One, two, three. Wait. This thing opened up, so. Okay, you ready?
Yeah.
Let's go. You gotta get under it, under. Well, you gotta press it up. Yo. Yeah. right, y'all, we got it fully loaded. Hey, it's your boy Brett, aka Splitty, aka B-Rett, because I put the in Madison. We're loaded up, everything's strapped in. I made sure of it, nice and secure. We're gonna go ahead and get this ramp and call it a day. We'll unload this baby tomorrow.
You gotta say it like Culver's. Culver's.
What's up, everybody? So it's day two. Yesterday we picked up the loads from Prairie du Chien. Pretty simple. Four hard workers makes the day go smooth. This job's important to me because I get to do this move with my guy Cliff. That's important to me. We've been on a lot of journeys in this job. I've been here 6 years, been to over 40 states. Very blessed in that end. But I am moving on to a different chapter, got a different opportunity, and it's time to move on. So this job's pretty important to me, and it's going pretty smooth, which makes it nice. Not too many left in this chapter. But yeah, it should be a pretty good day, pretty early day. Get home to the fam. Some good quality time in before I move on and hit it at 110% at this new gig. So yeah, we're about 15 minutes away from the unload. Looks like we got some blueberries and cherries ahead of us. It's the day in the life driving the truck.
Today's gonna be a good one to kind of wrap it up. We gotta go out of town and get out to Prairie du Chien. Today we'll close out in Madison.
Looks like we got a lot of one level houses out here. Appears this unload is gonna be just straight in.
All right, I got B's, I got LR's, U's, K's, S, mystery. Get what you need.